Hello, First Baptist Church family and others who might catch this video on our Facebook page. I'm Beth Honeycutt, the worship leader at First Baptist Church. You know, the world as we know it has changed so much in just a couple of weeks, and I'm sure you're like me, and you miss our regular gatherings to worship or meet with our life groups in person. I really miss our church family. But you know, it's caused me to be more thankful for my brothers and sisters in Christ. You are God's gift to me, and we're a gift to each other. Throughout the New Testament, we're instructed that we are one body, the body of Christ. And whether we're physically together or not, in Him, we are one. And you know, it's important to make intentional efforts to stay connected to one another. Life groups can do this through Zoom meetings or other technology, or just calls, text, or writing cards. I know that many of you are already doing a really terrific job of this, and I just want to encourage you to continue to stay connected to one another. I also encourage you to connect with your church family through worship, and this Sunday morning, we'll be having worship at 10:30, and through our FBC Garner Facebook page or through fbcgarner.org, our homepage, you can connect with us, and we'll worship together. Our worship team will lead you in worship, and then our pastor will continue to walk with us through Ephesians and his message. And then we'll worship together, though we are scattered in homes everywhere, and then maybe folks will join us. You can invite them to join us from anywhere. We can worship together as one, as the body of Christ. Our spirits are united as one. And you can connect to your church staff by emailing fbc@fbcgarner.org. You can submit needs that you might have, and we'll try to connect you with people who can help, or prayer requests or praises, how you've seen God at work, that you'd like to share with us. If you have an emergency need, you can call 772-1772, press 7 and leave a message, and someone will get back with you in just a few minutes. That's our minister on call. And we want you to know that we'll be glad to pray with your help in any way that we can. Also, there's a staff directory on our Get in Touch page that's on our website. And they're the individual staff that you'd like to get in touch with. Their names and contact information is listed. But finally, our church staff is praying for you. We know that these are uncertain times, and we are going through these uncertain times with you. We are meeting together weekly through our Zoom video meetings, and we're praying together for our church family. We love you. We care about you, and we're praying for our church family. We know that this is difficult for everyone, and we want you to know that we are praying for you. We love you. Finally, I want to read for you a portion of scripture that's found in Ephesians 3. Our pastor's walking with us through Ephesians. Let me share this with you as a closing prayer. It's a prayer from the Apostle Paul. It says, "For this reason, I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen." I hope the Lord will bless you as you're in your homes together. I pray that the Lord will strengthen you in your inner being. and you will know his peace throughout these times. I'm praying for you.